Oh, I want to ask you guys this question. You guys are not hip hop heads like me, so I'll ask. Is it Little Baby season and the end of the Drake season? You probably don't know.
I mean, you know, I'm not the biggest Aubrey fan.
Don't know why, but okay.
Little Baby is coming on hard, but I don't think
that sounds disgusting.
Pause. But I don't think he's eclipsed Drake.
No?
No.
Kevin Durant said in an interview that he, in the locker room, everybody plays a Little Baby, and he tries to play Drake, but they just be like, man, turn that off.
Right, but I think if Little Baby drops a song and Drake drops a song, Drake's song will still get more traction. Mm. Because, once again, my guy, Drake isn't for the men.
Yeah, he is.
No, that's why if you go into a basketball locker room and you try to play Drake, people are like, nah, man.
No.
Drake's over here singing to all my exes.
No.
Drake's here trying to slip into all my exes' DMs.
Oh, my God.
Drake's over here trying to get with the girls that I made legitimate.
Not true. Here's the thing. Kevin Durant is saying that at one point in time, they was bumping Drake in the locker room.
Mm.
Okay.
But then he started putting dudes' tattoos on himself, and they're like, whoa. Nah, I'm not about that life.
I don't think that that's the issue. Okay. What I'm saying is, clearly there's a disconnect between how old the people are on the team versus the 30-year-olds, the 32-year-olds that are bumping Drake from back in the day. Okay.
I think Drake's just corny.
Relax. I think, number one, Drake hasn't dropped anything seriously that is going to make people go crazy since if you're reading this. Okay. Views was dope, and it was the sound of whatever period that was, 2016. Scorpion didn't have that effect. Now, he did have the summer lit with the Kiki Challenge and the God's Plans, his biggest song ever, for some reason. I don't know why. I think that entire album is trash.
He put out two joints when the Toronto won, too. Put out that song.
But, I mean, those are like what I would consider Drake throwaways. Like, okay, I made this. Here you go. You like it. His throwaways are better than the average person's music.
And he did that song with Chris Brown that was...
That was a huge song.
Yeah, huge song for a while.
Huge.
I don't
song.
Think Lil
it came
Baby
slow, but it was huge.
I don't song. Think Lil Baby has put out a record as big as Drake has.
It's on the way.
I think Lil Baby's great. I think he has the younger generation for sure. And eventually, Drake is gonna get weaned off, right? As he grows older, he's not gonna be as popular as the next guy up or whatever. But
not gonna happen.
Is it Lil Baby? I don't know.
I think the issue here is that Drake is more talented than Lil Baby is at making music. Lil Baby kind of has this sound, his singular Atlanta sound. And then Drake can sing, he can rap, he can sing rap, he can swag rap, he can do all these things mixed together that Lil Baby doesn't have. So I think, yes, is Lil Baby, like, that is why Drake has eclipsed Lil Wayne. Because Lil Wayne didn't have the versatility that Drake has.
Yeah, but it depends on who you're asking, because people that grew up on Lil Wayne will... Oh, it's pandemonium right now.
Hey, girl.
Hey. I've never heard your dog bark in my life.
That's her. It's Amigo came home.
That's those are happy barks. She never barks like at people.
Got you. But what I'm saying is there are going to be people who grew up on Lil Wayne that will never say that Lil Wayne or Drake's better than Lil Wayne. Just the way you'll say nobody's ever going to be better than Drake because you grew up on Drake.
Drake is not my favorite rapper though.
But I don't think there's
50 Cent.
I don't think Drake's put out better I think Lil Wayne has multiple verses that are better than any Drake verse ever. I don't think Drake's best verse versus Lil Wayne's best verse. In my opinion.
Which is his best verse?
There was a time where Lil Wayne was jumping on everybody's song.
Same with Drake.
And he had the best verse on the song.
Facts. Same with Drake's.
Nah. I can't say the same for Drake. I don't think that's the same with Drake. I'm talking about I'm trying to think of the years.
Drake had 09 to 2015 on lock.
But not I'm saying not the way that Lil Wayne had his thing on.
Talking 2002 to 2010.
There was a time where people were like, there was this movement that Lil Wayne was better than Jay-Z.
Sure, but he also said that.
No, but what I'm saying is when you talk about Lil Wayne, like he's considered one of the greatest rappers of all time. Drake isn't.
Yeah, whoa, come on, man.
And yeah, this is where your bias is coming in, because there's not.
How could you say Drake is not one of the greatest of all time?
He's not. He's one of the most highest selling artists. He's one of the most popular artists. But as far as rappers,
yes, he's a very talented rapper.
Nah, man, he's been ghostwritten, like all that kind of stuff takes him out of the thing.
No, it doesn't.
Okay, but that's what I'm saying. You're a Drake homer. You can't see it.
No,
clearly.
That's not true. No.
Okay, then I mean, you've never said
just said that Scorpion is trash.
Okay, but then if you can see Drake realistically, you wouldn't consider him one of the greatest rappers of all time.
Okay, why?
Because one, he is more of a pop artist than a rapper.
So he's never rapped.
That's not what I said. I said he's more of a pop artist than a rapper.
How is he more of a pop
artist? Because he's more of like that singy, songy, like R&B flavor. His best songs aren't rap songs. His best songs are more like R&B-ish songs. Okay. Two, he's been ghostwritten, right? Ghostwriters, that automatically takes you out of the greatest rappers. The whole control, the whole like Kendrick Lamar versus Drake thing was that. The whole Meek versus Drake thing is
what
that.
Kendrick
the
Lamar whole thing? Because Drake watched Kendrick Lamar on.
Oh my God.
On. You know what I'm talking about.
They've never put out necessarily songs against each other. They did those like little BET clip things and all that kind of stuff.
This right here. You telling me that Kendrick watched Drake on this?
They're not even beef battling on that.
It's not beef battling, but Drake watched him on this song. And Drake watched Cole on that song that they was on.
I don't think so.
Wow. Why do you hate this guy?
I don't hate him at all. Mm-hmm. Why? Because I say that Lil Wayne is better than Drake. That means I hate Drake.
Do you know? You know Drake wrote for Lil Wayne, right?
Not in back when Lil Wayne, when Drake didn't know, when Lil Wayne wasn't in, or Drake wasn't in Lil Wayne's life.
Look, Chris, look.
I'm saying now Lil Wayne already admits that he has people write his music and all that kind of stuff. I'm talking about when Lil Wayne was actually doing music. He's already come out. Drake won't come out and say, yeah, I have people write for me and all this kind of stuff.
Wait, no.
No, he said reference tracks.
No, he did not say that. He said that me and the homie that lost his leg, I'm sorry, I forgot your name.
Q.
Yes.
Quentin Miller.
He said that they collaborated on it, if you're reading this. And then him and The Weeknd collaborated on Take Care. He has mentioned all of these things, that they collaborated, that he thinks that music is a collaborative process.
They wrote for you, dude.
Wow. And then Quentin Miller wrote that thing that said that he's seen Drake write his bars, so on and so forth.
I don't think Drake can't write.
You just think he's trash at it.
No, I don't think he's trash at writing it either. I think he's great. I'd say, well, you keep changing the question to fit whatever narrative you want to fit. Uh-huh. I don't think he's one of the greatest rappers of all time.
I just don't see how you could say that.
Because I just told you, he's an R&B. He's an R&B guy.
That's not true, though, okay. Because he's done R&B.
I think when you say his best hits, most of his best hits are going to be more of the singy, songy type songs. That
so
he
the
does.
Time stamp song, those are his best to me. The hits doesn't mean, what are Jay-Z's biggest hits? You know what I'm saying? Like
Big Pimpin',
New York. Like, that's not a mega rap song. We're talking about rap, not hits. Let's talk about raps.
Okay.
So if we're talking about rap,
I think Lil Wayne raps better than Drake.
Today?
No. I'm talking prime.
So have you heard the timestamp songs?
What do you mean timestamp songs?
You see, you ain't heard none of this stuff. I'm talking four. I'm talking about 4 p.m. in Calabasas, 5 a.m. in Toronto, draft day. This one right here, when he was going at Diddy.
All you self-promoters are janky. We established like the Yankees. This whole fucking game thankless. We moving militant, but somehow you the one tanking. No limit to why I could take it. And you know me as a crisp bottle sender. Check pick-upper. I thought we looked out for one another. Saw us all as brothers in a struggle to bless.
You know this song?
No. But just listening to it doesn't give me the same vibes that a Lil Wayne song gives me.
I'm going to give you this one. This is my favorite Drake song. This has some of the hardest rhymes in. It's on some old
Tommy Campos. I think Drake is a good artist.
No.
You want him to be the greatest. He's not the greatest.
You underestimated greatly. You did. You underestimated. Ever,
how long did it sure. really take
me? How long?
The part I love most is they need me more than they hate me. So they never take shots. I got everybody on safety. I can load every gun with bullets that fire backwards. You probably wouldn't lose a single rapper. Niggas make threats. Can't hear him over the laughter.
Look at that.
That's cause I'm headed to the bank, nigga. Sinatra lifestyle. I'm just
Here's one of my favorite lines he ever said. He said, In this rap game with me, y'all a bunch of corpses. But without me, y'all a bunch of orphans.
Ooh.
It's you being a hype man.
Ooh. I'll use even one of Drake's like things from the new Chris Brown bit. Ooh.
That's hard as hell.
He ain't Lil Wayne.
Lil Wayne hard too. Lil Wayne said he said he
got Fo-fo bulldog. My motherfucking pet. I pointed at you.
That's one of the worst Lil Wayne verses to.
That's not true, to. L. That's real a hard G's, Lil Wayne. Like
real G's moving silence like lasagna.
Y'all going to like the Carter 5 stuff. Like, come on, man. He had already started falling off. Like the Carter 4. Mm. Like the Carter 4 was cool, but it was like, that's when you started questioning if you really loved Lil Wayne. But if you went back to the leak, I'm me, swag surf, wash my shoes, that's when I'd be like, okay, you know what? Drake has never done that.
The mixtapes that Lil Wayne was dropping when he was in his prime. And Lil Wayne, even when he was with Hot Boys, he had like, he came on the track and he had the most memorable like lines on that when he was like part of the Hot Boys and all that kind of stuff. Then he went into this whole like, where he was doing the mixtapes and all this kind of stuff. Then he went into this like mode where I had never seen, like, probably only other person, I don't think I've ever seen a person that like, just had the consistent where he was on every single huge rap song. He would come on the remix or he would be part of the original song and his verse was just different, man.
I feel Drake did that 2009 to 2015. He went crazy.
I think Drake is, and maybe Drake is your generation's Lil Wayne. Maybe that's what it is. But I remember that, and I remember being talking to my boys and being like, dang, when does Lil Wayne
miss?
Not just miss. What like Lil Wayne is the best verse on every single song he's on.
I recognize that. This is high school for me, for sure.
And so I've never felt that about Drake, where he's the best. I think like he's been like, yo, his hook is nice, but I don't ever remember being like, dang, every single time Drake jumps on a song, he has the hardest verse. I don't remember feeling it the same way I used to feel with Lil Wayne. And that's just my opinion. That don't mean it make it right. That don't make it wrong.
I've never heard this before, Chris. I can't even believe that. Well, I did say a couple years ago that the Drake era was over. And somehow he navigated through Scorpion. I ever tell you guys I went to the Drake concert. I hate Scorpion. I think it's one of the worst albums ever.
But you know every single lyric.
I went to that concert ready to hate all the Scorpion. So I was singing with my nipples out. I've had a blast. I was like, man, I love this song. On the way home, I was listening to it. I was like, man, this song sucks. But at the concert, swept me off my feet.
I think Drake's consistent.
I think the moment he dropped that both verse on Gucci's East Atlanta Santa 2016 2017, that that to me is when Drake fell off. Like, he has moments where he's still brilliant, but
I like Drake. I like my favorite Drake songs are more where he's singing versus rapping.
I like him rapping more. I like the singing, but the rapping, like rap and rap well. That the stuff that like what he did on Views is just C+. Like Views is just okay, but Nothing Was the Same. Solid. Take Care. Solid. I think the greatest mixtape of all time is So Far Gone. Like, nothing has ever been better than that. Look. I'm just saying that just to anger him, Chris.
I'm not angry. I don't, and nothing that comes out of your mouth I take valid, because you got Drake so you like love Aubrey so much that obviously you and every woman are gonna say the same thing.
And every woman. Shots fired. That's crazy. My favorite is 50 Cent though.
I'm with you on 50. But I like 50 more as an entrepreneur than the rapper.
I like 50 just in general. Yeah. Like, I grew up listening to 50. I like everything about him. I just like the ruthlessness, the unable to be canceledness. I loved his music. I listened to music past Curtis. Like, I was bumping 187. Like, I like 50. I think that his verse on the Woo is like the best verse that he's done in a long time. Like, I just enjoy 50
Cent. Me too. And I love what he's branched off to. Like, when he speaks, when he does interviews, I learned so much about just entrepreneurism and psychology and how to navigate through different like rooms. Like, I don't know, everything that 50 does I like, but I think 50 is a better businessman than he is a rapper, and I think he's a really good rapper.